Hello, my name is Jana Emmer, and I am the director of the BYU Museum of Art, and I am delighted to introduce you to our newest exhibition, which is in the lower level of the museum. It's called Fields of Labor and Recovery, A Portrait of Utah During the Great Depression and World War II. In this exhibition, we have collaborated with Dr. James Swenson, a professor of art history and photography, to put together this exhibition that showcases five photographers who came to Utah under government programs to chronicle what was happening in Utah from 1936 to 1942. One of those photographers was Dorothea Lange. She's probably most well known for her Migrant Mother that she photographed in 1936, of a mother surrounded by her children in a migrant camp in California. And interestingly, that photograph she did in March of 1936, and right after that, she came to Utah and came to a mining town called Consumers, Utah. And that is what you see behind me. This area of the exhibition has a couple of photographs, a handful of photographs from this mining town. And part of her project was to show the difficult conditions that these miners were enduring during the Depression, and some of their poverty and the challenges they were facing, as well as their resilience. And that is really what she did. She does so well, focusing on people and their struggles and getting a sense of what they're going through. And so when we look at behind me, you'll see this is a photograph from what is called the Blue Blaze Mine. And here you see one of the male coal workers, a coal miner. He's working. If you look close, you can see he's wearing very worn, used clothing and is carrying a shovel or some sort of tool over his shoulder. And then he has this lunch pail all over his arm as well, so indicating the length of the day that they're working all day. And if you look at his face, there's a definite kind of strength there and dedication, but you'll also get a sense of the grimness, of the difficulty of what these miners were going through day after day. And Lange really captures that well in this composition, but she also was interested not only in what the male coal miners were doing, but also how it impacted their families. And so right next to that photograph, we see an image here of a woman and her two children. She's carrying one, the other she's holding their hand as they go through. And again, this is March, so you see snow everywhere. It's still cold. You notice that they're not wearing coats, so they don't have a lot of resources. And they're walking down, kind of stumbling through and trying not to trip over the snow and the kind of rocky terrain as they go to these homes. The homes were known for being very crowded, dilapidated, leaky roofs, very difficult conditions. And in fact, Lange wrote in a lot of her descriptions that these areas these mines were the dumping grounds of the West. So she's really focusing on showing the difficulty here as they trudge through the snow or as they work in the mines. And I think that was a part of her project that she did really well. And in fact, Consumers did not survive. It's a ghost town today. So we see their struggle, and that remains a part of our history during the Great Depression. And I think that's a great legacy of these photographs. They continue to tell the story of those who have gone before here in the state of Utah, the struggles they endured, and we can learn from those as we look at them. So I hope that you will be able to come and enjoy this exhibition in the museum. And thanks for tuning in today.